This is Headline News. Hello everyone, today I'll be talking about the immigrant caravan. About 600 of the 85,000 immigrants waiting to enter California from Mexico are confirmed as criminals. Said by President Trump, many people worry that these criminals will cause problems because these murderers and many other things. Some are also worried that these immigrants will take their jobs and do better. President Trump states that the fake news are putting children and women in front of these criminals on camera to make his decision look bad. The U.S., but he doesn't want that these people are criminals. A couple of the immigrants marching spoke and said they want equality. They said all of the criminals are taking their hard work money. There is heard to be another caravan forming somewhere near Ecuador.
Hi everyone, we are back with breaking news. This week on December 10th in Wyoming, we had a woman that drowned trying to save her dog from the cold icy water in the pond that she drowned in. But let's be honest here, been a tiny bit more careful than she was before. I understand how she reacted. She could have taken way more precaution in that situation during that time. But I understand that dog's a man's best friend, but she could have been way more careful than she was. And she did work for the local school district too, but we know how hard it is to find another teacher for the school. The police did launch a rescue, but all they found was a body of the woman. That's it for Headline News.
Hi, my name is Jamie.
And my name is Miguel. This is local news.
The two-vehicle head-on crash happened shortly after 7 p.m. at 63rd and McKinley. According to the preliminary investigation, Ms. Harriet was eastbound on McKinley in a Chevrolet Cruze. Authorities say the car crossed the center line and hit a westbound Toyota Highlander driven by Jordy Bierman, 36 of Blair.
And we will be talking about Santa brings joy to children in the hospital. Santa made a stop at the Nebraska Medical Center on Saturday to bring some holiday cheer to children and their families.
That was nice. What we will be talking about next is woman drowned in icy pond while trying to rescue her dog. In live reports, family members began searching for Cash, and when her dog returned home without her, they were unable to find her, prompting them to call police for help. Just after midnight, search crews discovered Cashman's body in the ice of a pond at the park. Firefighters tried unsuccessfully to revive her.
What we are talking about now is 7-year-old battling brain cancer hopes to lead football team to big game. Here is the news about it. Yes, the team's captain and kicker was diagnosed with brain cancer when he was 2. He's unable to take part in any contract due to his condition, but that didn't stop Coach General Derpy from giving just a spot on the team.
Well, that's all we have for you. See you next week.
Hi, it's Brooklyn,
Rainey, and Charlie. We are back with the weekly banger of sports updates. First up is Braylon with a story about the NBA.
LeBron versus D-Wade, his last dance. Can you believe that D-Wade and LeBron faced off for the last time? LeBron James and D-Wade will face each other in Staples Center. The Lakers won, 108-105. D-Wade would miss the game-time three-pointer, but they got the ball back, then Justice Winslow missed it. After LeBron got the rebound, the game was over. LeBron and Dwayne had a hug after the game and talked about how they couldn't believe it was their last time playing. They were teammates on the Cavs and Heat, also were opponents for a while, but they had their last dance this week. Dwayne had 15 points, 10 assists, and 5 rebounds. LeBron had 28 points, 12 assists, and 9 rebounds. No matter what Dwayne and LeBron will have a great friendship. Next up is Rainey with our story about volleyball.
Have you ever wondered about volleyball's history or how the sport all started? Well, that's what my newscast is about today. Volleyball became famous by playing in its schools and clubs and playing with friends and it traveled across the world. Volleyball was originally called Mintonette and was invented in 1895 by a man named William Morgan. Volleyball was thought of as 4 years after basketball. William Morgan graduated from Springfield College of the YMCA. and designed this game to be a combination of basketball, baseball, tennis, and handball. The first volleyball net was a tennis net. 2 years after volleyball was designed, they played a game of two beach man volleyball. The professional type of volleyball came out a few years later. In 1900, the first ever volleyball was designed and came out. In 1916, the types of plays were invented, including the set and spike. Then in 1920, the three hits only on each side became a rule. The cool thing is, in 1964, volleyball was introduced to the Tokyo Olympics. In 1995, the 100-year anniversary of volleyball happened that year. There is the history of volleyball and how it is invented and thought of. Next up is Charlie with a soccer story.
To finish it off, hi, I'm Charlie. This is a story about Shannon Lee Miller. She was born March 10, 1977. She is an American former gymnast. She was the 1993 and 1994 World All-Around Champion and the 1996 Olympic Balance Beam Champion. The 1995 Pan American Games and the member of a gold medal winning team, Magnificent Seven, at the 1996 Olympics. Miller was the most decorated U.S. gymnast, male or female, at the Olympic Games, which means she won a lot of medals. Seven in total, actually, with 16 world championships and Olympic medals between 1991 to 1996. That's it for sports news.
Hi, my name is Tabitha.
Hi, my name is Sierra.
We are back with more celebrity. Did you know that Caitlyn G is leaving the NBCs and no one knows why she's leaving?
Did you know that Miley Cyrus used to bully Hailey Baldwin when they were younger? Well, now they're good friends.
Did you know that Ellen, she considers leaving her daytime talking show? That's so sad.
Kendall Jenner has a secret admirer. Last week, she got a mystery letter about how much this person loves her. At the bottom, the name is blurred out, but the latest update is that Harry Styles wrote the love letter to her. Whitney Thor from My Big Fabulous Life has found a new boyfriend buddy. She's starting her season of shows this winter.
For today, celebrity gossip this week.
Hi, I'm Mackenzie.
I'm Sophia.
And I'm Nairi.
And you're watching Celebrity of the Week. And we are going to spill the tea on Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift was born on December 13th, 1989.
Happy late birthday to Taylor Swift.
Taylor Swift was born in Reading, Pennsylvania.
She has a younger brother named Austin.
Taylor's grandfather had been a professional opera singer, and Taylor followed her steps.
At the age of 12, she learned how to play the guitar and started writing her own songs.
At the age of 16, she released the song Love Story.
In 2010, she released her single Mean and won 2 Grammy Awards.
Okay, now it's time for the tea.
Taylor Swift and Katy Perry both dated John Mayer.
Taylor Swift wrote the song Bad Blood because of Katy Perry.
Taylor released her album Reputation in November.
The image of the snake is when Kim Kardashian called her a snake on Twitter.
Now
it's for our bonus celebrity, Selena Gomez.
Selena Gomez was born July 22, 1992. She started a show called Wizards of Waverly Place, which started airing in 2007 and ended in 2012 with 4 seasons. Selena Gomez plays Mavis in Hotel Transylvania. She has earned numerous awards throughout her career, including an ALMA Award, an American Music Award, an MTV Video Music Award, a People's Choice Award, 2 Billboard Women in Music Awards, and 18 Teen Choice Awards. On May 10, 2018, Gomez released a new single from 13 Reasons Why Season 2 soundtrack titled Back to You. Selena Gomez is an executive producer on the show 13 Reasons Why.
Thanks for watching. See you next week.
Hi, my name is Angel.
Hi, my name is Justin.
Hi, my name is Tyler.
And this is a video game news on the week.
A new Call of Duty Black Ops 4 first premium DLC has been leaked last night. Black Ops 4 player in Australia noticed that they were able to download and play the DLC. Two new multiplayer maps, Madagascar and Elevation. Some players took the opportunity to post footage of both Madagascar and Elevation to YouTube. Players were also able to access and post footage of the new Dead of the Night Zombies mode, confirming that the actors Kiefer Sutherland and Charles Dance appear in the new mode. As Edgame points out, Call of Duty DLC packs have traditionally included four new maps alongside a zombie entry. A total of 12 maps are said they plan for Black Ops 4. Also, over six releases of two maps each instead of the traditional three releases of four maps each. Now on to Tandem with Fortnite News.
It was rumored that Avengers could be in the launch of Fortnite. The rumor was started because the data miners have been poking around in the game files of patch 7.01 and discovered that Thanos might be making a return to Fortnite. Thanos got a fine tuning, so if he does come back, then he would be hopefully be good to go from the outset. The reason they thought Thanos was going to come back in Fortnite patch 7.01 is because there was a code name for Thanos. In the beginning, that was Karma. And the code name for patch 7.01 was Karma Disappear 01, which had Fortnite fans wondering if it would come back to the game. Now the true information is out with the patch Wednesday, and it is actually revealed that it is an actual Infinity Sword from the game, Infinity Blade. And it is not the Infinity Gauntlet. A sword grants superpowers, and I am sure players will be fighting over it every day.
Hi, I'm Angel. Today on Video Game News of the Week, we will be discussing about Red Out on IGN.com. This guide contains locations, strategies for each other, legendary animal, and legendary fish in Red Dead Redemption 2. There are 29 legendary animals to hunt in Red Dead Redemption 2, including 16 animals and 13 legendary fish. Each legendary animal and fish is the apex of their species and are found in a specific location, which author will note in his map by sketching a crown in an animal when nearby. That's all for today. Have a great day. Goodbye.
Hello, this is the Online Game of the Week, and my name is Ryan. The Online Game of the Week is Wings.io. In the game, you play as a plane and try to kill other planes. It is an amazing game that you can play with friends. You can change the design of the plane and the color of the design. The aim of the game is to get the most points and kill the most enemies. You can grab weapons that get dropped from the sky or from dead enemies. You can also kill warships that attack every single plane. You can also grab the laser, which is the strongest weapon in the game. The types of weapons are minigun, bomb, sniper, shotgun, fist, and laser. There is water at the bottom, so if you fly right above it, it splits. You can also stall, and it is fun to kill someone while falling. You can also name yourself whatever you want, but do not put any appropriate words because kids play this. I'm out of time now. Have fun playing this game because it is a blast.
Well, that's it for today. See you next time.
And today we're talking about technology news. Now we'll be talking about DJI Mavic 2. This drone has a great image and video quality with unusual zoom, long battery life, fast, stable, quiet flight, packed with safety features, and all. It has a phone design. You'll need to connect an Android or iOS device running DJI's Companion app to the controller in order to fly the Mavic 2. It has dynamic range and rich color depth. It will cost $1,250.
Sugar Basically is a hologram of a smartphone that is touchscreen and goes on your wrist. This device will cost about $400, but there will be two storage sizes, the 16GB and the 32GB. Also, when you touch the hologram, it reacts to your skin, but nobody can get one because they do not exist yet, but they will come out in 10 different colors. And that's it for technology news.
Welcome back.
Hi, I'm Cynthia.
And I'm Brianna. So, Cynthia, what is the app of the week this time?
It's Spotify.
Can you explain some facts about it?
Spotify is a music streaming app where you can listen to almost any artist.
Who made it?
It was made by Daniel Ek and Martin Lorenzo, then developed by a Swedish company, Spotify Technology.
When was it released?
Spotify was released on October 7th, 2008.
Wow, 10 years of streaming music.
Yeah. Also, fun fact, it's available in 78 regions.
Where is it available?
It's available for most smart devices, including Windows, iOS, Windows Phone, and Android smartphones and tablets. Also, Amazon Fire TV devices and the PlayStation 3, PlayStation 4, and Xbox.
How can I use Spotify?
You can search music of any artist, album, style, playlist, or record label. Users can create, edit, and share playlists and track on social media too. You can make playlists with other users. Spotify provides access to more than 40 million songs.
Wow, that's a lot of things I can do.
Yeah, it is.
Also, how many people use Spotify?
It has 200 million monthly active users, including 90 million paying subscribers.
Is it free?
Yes, but you can upgrade to Spotify Premium or Spotify Family for better services.
So, Cynthia, do you have a Spotify?
Yes, I do.
Anyways, that was App of the Week.
Come back next week to watch the next App of the Week.
Hi, my name is Jordan,
Bailey,
and Sierra.
Did you know on the 12th day of Christmas cost about $1.3 billion?
Did you know the image of Santa Claus flying his sleigh began in 1819?
Did you know the reindeer pulling Santa's sleigh are more than likely female?
Did you know the original Rudolph did not have a red nose? Did you know America's first batch of eggnog was made in the Jamestown settlement in 1607?
Did you know Santa Claus originated in an ad?
Did you know We Wish You a Merry Christmas was originally a threat?
Did you know the three traditional colors of most Christmas decorations are red, green, and gold?
Did you know spiders and spiders' webs are often used as Christmas tree decorations?
If you gave all the gifts listed in the 12 days of Christmas, it would equal 364 gifts.
Almost 28 sets of Legos are sold every second during the Christmas season.
We hope you enjoy.
Hello, I am Ryan. I will be your holiday guide.
Hello, I'm Kitty, and I love unicorns.
Welcome to the holidays of the week.
Your holiday guide will be talking about
Big Cookie Day.
I love cookies. They're so yummy. So what do you do National Bake Cookie Day?
You simply bake cookies.
I would bake M&M's cookies. What would you bake?
I would bake chocolate chips because they are tasty.
Ryan, did you know that is on December 18th?
No, I thought that was Hanukkah.
Haha, very funny, Ryan.
Also, if you bake more than you can eat, you can wrap them up and give them to your family and friends. Except for me, I'll only give them to myself. Plan on getting me loads of cookies.
Do you know what another holiday of the week is?
Well, I do. It is National Crossword Puzzle Day.
Oh, that's fun. What is the information about it, and why is it around Christmas time?
Well, it is about the puzzles made on this day, 1913. The creator of this masterpiece is unknown, but we can all assume that his invention was one of a kind, and his parents have a reason to say, get off that phone and go play that puzzle.
That is so interesting, and I could really see his or her mom say that. Also, I did some research and found out more things.
Really? What? I am interested to hear what you looked up.
These puzzles became so popular, the competitions were held to see who has the fastest to complete them correctly.
I know that I would definitely lose that. Probably take me one day if I'm allowed to use Google.
Haha, I might win that competition.
Well, that's it for Holiday of the Week. Bye!
Hi, my name is Rihanna.
And my name is Jamie.
And we are here today with Joke of the Day. So, Jamie, how was your day?
Good, how about yours?
Good, but hey, Jamie, why did the math book look so sad?
Why?
Because it had too many problems.
That was a good joke, but I have one. What do you call a sad cup of coffee?
What?
A espresso.
That was a good one. But why did the Scarecrow win the Nobel Prize?
Why?
Because he was outstanding in his field.
What is it like to win the Super Bowl?
What?
Who knows? They are buffalo.
That was a good one. That's me and Jamie with Joke of the Day.
Have a good day.